Dear students, let's discuss the potentiometer experiment which we generally execute in a laboratory. We'll follow step-by-step procedure to execute the experiment to determine an unknown EMF. Here you can see on this board a wire of 10 meter long length. A wire of 10 meter length is connected between two terminals A and B. And let us take this board on a horizontal table. And on one side of the wire, here we connect an accumulator battery of known EMF EB. Along with that, we connect a rheostat with an ammeter and a switch. This is our primary circuit. And here you can see, as soon as the switch is closed, a current flows through the ammeter. Here, let us note down the value of current in ammeter. Say it is 3.5 ampere. Now, in this situation, we try to keep the current constant at 3.5 ampere because if it changes, the potential gradient across the potentiometer wire will also change. Now, for this situation, time to time, we need to adjust the rheostat so that its current will be maintained. Now, we consider its secondary circuit by taking a battery of unknown EMF here we have connected with the connecting wires, and the other terminal of battery is connected with the galvanometer along with the jockey. Now say if the jockey is connected to the potentiometer wire, then at various terminals we can see there are some points on wire where the galvanometer deflection is changing from left to right. That means between these two wires only we are going to get the null point. So, if we slide the jockey gradually from one side to another, we can locate the terminal. We can locate the point where there is null deflection in the galvanometer, and this null deflection length from point A can be seen here as this is the fifth wire. So, the total length here is 4 meter plus the length from left side to the jockey, which if we measure on the scale, you can see it is 56 centimeter. So in this situation, the total length we are getting here is balancing length is 456 centimeter. So in this situation, the unknown EMF can be written as lambda L. The value of potential gradient we can directly determine by using the method we have studied earlier, or we can determine this potential gradient by replacing this unknown battery with a standard battery of EMF ES. Now you can see if this battery is replaced by a standard battery ES, and again we balance this battery on the potentiometer length, you can see now it is balanced on the seventh wire at a distance 37 centimeter on the scale. That means the total length LS, which is the balancing length for the standard battery, here you can see it is 637 centimeter. So we can write that a standard battery EMF can be written as lambda LS. And using this relation, we can find the value of lambda as ES upon 637. And if we substitute the value of lambda over here, this will give us ES multiplied by 456 divided by 637. If we just substitute the value of a standard battery EMF over here, we are getting the EMF of unknown battery which we were intended to measure using this experiment. But you must be very careful in the whole experiment. The current in primary circuit has to remain same. If sometime the current drops, then by reducing the rheostat value, you need to keep the current in the primary circuit to be same at this 3.5 ampere. Otherwise, the values of balancing lengths we are calculating will not at all be appropriate. So, in this experiment, we are taking those values of a standard lengths which are at a constant primary circuit current. So you must be very careful about the whole experiment, and this is the way how we calculate the unknown EMF in terms of potential gradient or in terms of a standard battery.